Dear student, myself SS Kamble from Government Polytechnic Washim, presenting the e-contents of subject Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering. This lecture contains the capacitor, its specification and color coding. This is our lecture number 3. After studying this lecture, the students will be able to identify the capacitors in various electronic circuits. Now, what is the capacitor? Capacitor is a passive component which is the most common component used in various electronic circuits. Capacitor has the capacitance, and capacitance is the ability to store electrical energy in the component. This capacitor consists of two parallel conducting plates separated by an insulating material known as dielectric. The amount of charge that a capacitor can store per unit voltage is called as capacitance. Capacitor stores energy in the form of electric field that is established by the opposite charges on the two plates. Hence, the capacitance of capacitor is given by C equals to epsilon into A by D, where the epsilon is the permittivity of the material. The value of the permittivity changes from material to material, which is filled between the two conducting plates of capacitor. A is the area of the conducting plate and D is the distance between the two conducting plates. And hence, the capacitance of a capacitor is directly proportional to permittivity and area of the conducting plate, and inversely proportional to the distance between the two plate. The unit of capacitor. Capacitor has the unit farad. Farad is the basic unit of capacitance, named after Michael Faraday, a famous scientist, symbolized by the letter F. And hence, 1 farad becomes equals to the change of 1 volt across the plates, results in the movement of 1 coulomb of current. But a farad is a large unit of capacitance, and hence the capacitance value is expressed in smaller unit, that is the microfarad, nanofarad, picofarad. Microfarad means 10⁻⁶ farad, nanofarad is 10⁻⁹ farad, picofarad means 10⁻½ farad. The unit for the capacitor is shown here. As the capacitor may be non-polarized, it means no any polarity is to be shown here. For the polarized capacitor, here the one plate having the polarity positive, and for the variable capacitor, this arrow indicates the variation in the capacitance value. These are the symbol for capacitor. Now, charge storing action of capacitor. When a DC voltage is connected across the capacitor, positive charges starts flowing towards the one plate of capacitor and negative charge towards the other. Due to dielectric charge starts accumulating on the plate surface, potential of the plates increases from 0 towards the potential of the battery. When the charge develop on the plates becomes equals to the potential of the battery, flow of charge stops and the voltage across the capacitor becomes equals to the potential of the battery. In this way, the charge is to be stored on the capacitor. Now, we see the specification of the capacitor. we see the classification of the capacitor. Capacitor is mainly classified on the basis of value of capacitor as a fixed capacitor and variable capacitor. For the fixed capacitor, the value of the capacitor becomes to be fixed here. There is no change in the value here. For the variable capacitor, there is variation in the value of the capacitor. Fixed capacitor is further classified into electrolytic capacitor and electrostatic capacitor. Electrolytic capacitor means that is the electrolytic solution is filled between the two conducting plates. Which type of conducting plate is used? Accordingly, the capacitor is classified as a tantalum and a aluminium capacitor. Then the electrostatic capacitor, which is also the fixed capacitor. Electrostatic capacitor is further classified depending on which type of dielectric material is used between the two conducting plates, and accordingly the capacitors is classified as a mica capacitor, ceramic capacitor, plastic capacitor and paper capacitor. Now the variable capacitor, the value of this capacitance can be changed. This capacitor is provided with the shaft or notch, and by moving the position of the shaft or notch, the capacitance of a capacitor can be varied. And again, depending on which type of dielectric is filled between the conducting plate, the variable capacitor is also classified as a ceramic capacitor, air capacitor, mica capacitor and a plastic capacitor. Capacitor specification. Capacitor's working voltage indicates the maximum safe limit of DC voltage applied across a capacitor to prevent the dielectric breakdown. If the capacitor is rated at 100 volts, it means that no voltage greater than 100 volts should be applied across its plate. If the capacitor is connected across the AC circuit, then the peak value of AC voltage should be compared to the DC working voltage of the capacitor, so that the peak to peak value of the applied voltage here is find out, and the peak value of this voltage should not be increased beyond its DC working voltage. For example, if the applied voltage is 40 volts peak to peak value, then the peak value of the voltage is 20 volts, and therefore the DC working voltage rating of the capacitor should be minimum of 20 volts. The second specification is the insulation resistance. Insulation resistance of a capacitor is important in most of the circuit and measures the resistance offered to a DC current flowing through the capacitor under steady state condition. Next specification is the capacitive reactance. It is the opposition offered by a capacitor to an alternating signal applied to it. Reactance of the capacitor is given by XC equals to XC equals to 1 upon twice pi FC, where the F is the frequency of the signal, C is the capacitance of the capacitor, and XC is denoted in ohm. If the frequency of the input signal F is 0, it means that there is the infinite reactance. And if the frequency of the applied signal is large or infinite, the reactance offered is to be by the capacitor is 0. And hence we say that reactance is inversely proportional to the frequency of the applied signal. The next specification, that is the power factor, indicates the ratio of resistance to reactance at the operating frequency. Power factor is usually expressed as a percentage For a good quality capacitor, power factor should be as small as possible. It should be zero value. In the next specification is the equivalent series resistance. Equivalent series resistance represents the power loss taking place in a capacitor. It may be possible that some power or energy stored across the capacitor may be leaked, and hence the equivalent series resistance should be the very important factor about the capacitance. It is defined as a ratio of reactance to the quality factor. Capacitor with low ESR or the equivalent series resistance U is used in high current performance application. Then the quality factor. Quality factor is the ratio of the energy stored to the dissipated per cycle. Hence, this quality factor indicates the component's ability to store energy compared to energy it wastes. Then the temperature coefficient. Here there may be change in the value of capacitance because of the change in temperature, and hence the temperature coefficient is again one of the important factor. Tolerance here. Tolerance indicates the change in the value of capacitance from its original value. This tolerance is also indicated in percentage. Then the CV ratio indicates the ratio of capacitance of capacitor to volume, which indicates the capacitance density. The CV product is the product of capacitance and voltage. It measures the efficiency of capacitor and total charge stored by the capacitor. In this way, whenever the user select the capacitor for the specific circuit or the specific application, all this specification becomes to be important. Now we see the color coding of capacitor. The value of the capacitor can be find out by four main ways: by using numerals, by using color code, by using character, or sometimes the direct printing of value on capacitor. First, we see how the value of the capacitor is find out by using the numerals. Sometimes on the surface of the capacitor, three digits are to be present. Out of these three digits, the first two digits indicate the first and second significant value of the capacitor, third digit as the multiplier, and we have to multiply this whole value by 10 to the power minus 12 so that we can convert the value into the standard unit picofarad. Here we take the just example. Here 773 is to be present on the surface of the capacitor. Out of this 773, the first and second significant digit is 7 and 7, third is the multiplier, and hence is I multiplied by 10 to the power 3. This value is multiplied by 10 to the power minus 12 as per our third rule. Whenever we apply the law of indices, the final resultant value is 77 into 10 to the power minus 9. Minus 9 means nano here, and final standard value of this capacitor is 77 nanofarad. Similarly, for we see the second example, that is the 124. The first two numbers, that is the first and second significant digit in the value of the capacitor, third is the multiplier, that is the 4, and hence I write here the 10 to the power 4. Multiply this value by the standard value picofarad, 10 to the power minus 12. After applying law of indices, the resultant value becomes equals to 12 into 10 to the power minus 8. And if I convert this value into the standard unit, it becomes equals to 120 nanofarad. Similarly, we do for the 225. Its final value is to be 2.2 microfarad. We can also find the value of the capacitance by means of the color coding present on the surface of the capacitor. If the capacitor is colored with the number of the bands, then we have to always choose from the top. The first top color band indicates the first significant digit. The second color is the second significant digit. third is the multiplier, and we have to multiply this by the 10 to the power minus 12, that is in the picofarad. Then the fourth band is the tolerance, and here the fifth color band indicates the working voltage of the capacitor. Here the number of capacitors are to be shown. These capacitors are electrolytic capacitor, metal capacitor, then the mica capacitor, variable capacitor. Such various capacitors are to be shown. Again, to remember the sequence of the color, we have to just remember the color statement. B.P. Roy of Great Britain has a very good wife, and the numbers assigned to each color is same. Multiplier of each color is to be same. Tolerance is to be shown here, and the voltage is also shown here. Working voltage for the every color code is to be shown here from black towards this white. Here we take one example. It is the orange blue. For the orange color, we take here the first significant digit. Three. For the second orange, the second significant digit is to be 3. Third is the multiplier blue, and hence I write here the 10 to the power 6. We have to convert this value into the picofarad, and hence I multiply this with the 10 to the power minus 12. And hence the resultant value of this capacitor having the unit 10 to the power minus 12 having the unit F. Now if I convert this into the standard value, that is the 33 into the 10 to the power minus 6 here, and I write here also the 33 microfarad. The second example is to be given. The first is the yellow, second is the violet, third is again the yellow. The value assigned to the color yellow is 4, hence I write here the first significant digit. The second color is the violet, value assigned to the violet color is 7, this is the second significant digit. Third is the multiplier, that is the yellow, is again we have to multiply by 10 to the power 4, and we have to convert it into the picofarad, and hence I multiply this value by 10 to the power minus 12. Here the this is in the farad. Now if I do the calculation, it becomes the 47 into the 10 to the power minus 8, and if I want to convert it into the standard unit, it becomes to be 470 nanofarad by means of character. Sometimes on the surface of the capacitor, 3K3 or 1K or some combination of number and alphabet is to be taken or written. Then also we find the value of the capacitor. Simply the alphabet with the two digits to be present on the surface of the capacitor, we have to replace the alphabet by means of the decimal point, and hence we have to replace the alphabet K or the alphabet M by means of the decimal point. If there is the K, multiply by 10 to the power 3. If there is the M, multiply by 10 to the power 6. Then the most important in the capacitor, multiply the value of capacitance by 10 to the power minus 12. Okay, these are the steps which are to be followed to find out the value of the capacitor. Now we see the example. If there is a 3K3 on the surface of the capacitor, then I simply replace the K by decimal point. Then K stands for the kilo, and hence I multiply by 10 to the power 3. Again, according to the rule, I multiply by 10 to the power minus 12. I just do the calculation. It becomes to be 3.3 into the 10 to the power minus 9. Minus 9 stands for the nanofarad, and hence the final value of the capacitor is 3.3 nanofarad. Similarly, here the capacitor surface contains the 1K. Here I replace the K by means of the decimal point. It becomes to be the 1.0. K stands for the 10 to the power 3, multiply it by 10 to the power minus 12. It becomes to be 1.0 into 10 to the power minus 9, and standard V value becomes to be 1 nanofarad. In this way, by means of character, we can also find the value of the capacitor. Now we see the application of the capacitor. Capacitor is again used in almost most of the circuits here. The main application of the capacitor is variable frequency oscillator, signal generator, radio receiver, TV receiver, tuned amplifier, filter circuit, and DC regulated power supply. The most frequently asked questions are: define capacitor, state the specification of capacitors, define capacitor reactance, state the classification of capacitor, draw the symbol of capacitor, state its unit, find the value of capacitor from the color code or the number, or find the color code of capacitor from the value. If you understood the content of my video, please like my video and give the subscription to my channel. Thank you.